House after house destroyed by fire. Village after village completely deserted. Journalists were taken on a rare trip organized by the Myanmar government to Mongdor township in Rakhine state.
Terrorists burn the Muslim houses and villages to destabilize the region. They do this to make it more difficult for troops to pursue them.
Government leaders offered no evidence to support their allegations. What Myanmar army commanders call a counter-terrorism operation is continuing against Rohingya fighters after they attacked security posts on August 25th, killing 12 people. Some rights groups say the Muslim minority is being targeted in a campaign that's increasingly looking like ethnic cleansing. The Rohingya are reviled here, particularly by the other main ethnic group in the state, the Rakhine or Arakan, who are mainly Buddhists.
All Bengali people is terrorists. All Arakan people never believe them. Never believe them. Never living together. Cannot live in together. Never, never, never. We don't like Bengali people. We don't like Bengali people. They are not their country. The Bengali country, not Bengali land. They come from Bangladesh.
While the fighting goes on, a humanitarian disaster is threatening the rest of Rakhine state. The UN and other aid groups have suspended operations because they say it's unsafe for their staff, a decision that affects 250,000 people. The Red Cross says it's increasing its operations to fill the void, but the government will coordinate and facilitate distribution. Some Rohingya fear they'll be neglected.
I'm not scared. I'm praying to Allah every day for our fate.
The security crackdown is also making life more unbearable for people in other parts of Rakhine state, Myanmar, as well as causing an exodus of Rohingya refugees into Bangladesh and a humanitarian crisis there. Florence Looi, Al Jazeera, Yangon.